EMP.
Whoa.
Broadcasting from our universal resources, I'm going to show you how to eat really cheap today on the DMP Soul Hama cooking show. So what I did was went to the local market that supplies fresh food in the Oregon community, and they had the steelhead salmon from just harvested from the ocean, which could be a good thing and a bad thing. They just had the earthquake in Japan, so I don't know how much nuclear stuff is in here. So anyway, if you look at this, these are like, let's see if I could maneuver this camera. These are the scraps of the fish. So they take the fish and they fillet it, and these are the pieces that are left over. As you can see, they're like, but there's still a lot of like fish on there. See how long that is, ladies and gentlemen? So these scraps are like $1.50, $2 a pound, whereas the steak that they cut off of this fish is probably about $14, $15 a pound. So what I'm going to do is show you how to make a fish soup off of the scraps and eat lovely. This probably cost about $5 for all this. So live on the DMP Soul Hama show, cooking show, we're going to show you how to make a fish soup. So basically what I did was I took the fish and I cut them. This is fresh fish, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. It feels so soft, the texture, the redness in there. There's no dye involved in this. It smells really robust. And so I took the fish and I parceled them out. Now this is sake. This is like an Oregon, like, this is one of the parts that people live, one of the reasons why people live in Oregon, because the food is just really good. So this is the sake. See, like, there. It's really, really nice.
Yo, peace, it's Gift to Gab, Blackalicious Quantum Projects, cooling on a DMP Soul Hama show in Portland, Oregon. Peace.
So what we're going to do with this fish here is we have these, like, fillets, and we're going to put into this bowl here. Next thing I'm going to do is go into my cabinet here and pick out some seasoning. I think we'll go with the rosemary. This is dried rosemary, but it was fresh picked. And we're going to go with some pepper. So we have the rosemary and pepper. And then we're gonna some celery seed. We're gonna go back here, and I'm gonna get some fresh paprika. So there you go. Live on the DM. This is very good stuff, very flavorful, very robust. So we're going to use some black sea salt. We're going to use some pompeian extra virgin olive oil.
Hey.
We have a pot. We have our fresh ingredients right here that we just pulled out of the cabinet. We're going to take the gas stove and turn it on. And a fire. We're going to take our nice stainless steel pot here. And we're just going to let it warm up a little bit. We want it to get nice and warm. Stainless steel pot. We're going to take the olive oil here. And we're going to pour some into. Be very generous.
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt this program to bring you a special report from the United Shoestring Broadcasting News Service.
We interrupt our programming.
Chuck-a-con.
We are to seek a fallout shelter immediately. If you cannot find a fallout shelter, local authorities and the National Guard will lead you to one. Make sure you have all necessary supplies in your fallout shelter, such as food, water, medical supplies, and a battery-powered radio.
20 years ago, a whale crashed into the shores of New York City.
So we're going to go into the refrigerator here, and we're going to pull out the these peppers right here. We're going to dig those out. Just clean them up. So we have these peppers, and then we're going to just bring them over here. Just want to show you real quick how nice that elephant garlic peeled. We have elephant garlic here that we chopped up, and we made them really big because what's going to happen is when they go into that very hot olive oil, they're going to like liquidate. Shake them around there a little bit.
I'll just get them very flavored.
Come on, buddy. All right, what are you looking for?
So we have our pan. We got the heat so high. And so now it's time to add in the peppers. So we're going to take the peppers and put into their peppers. So yeah, the elephant, garlic, and the peppers, and it's over high heat. just roll it there. Get that going there, ladies and gentlemen. Live on the DMP Soul Hama Show. At this point, we want to take our pepper and we just want to add just a little bit in there.
Now, that's probably about 2 tablespoons of pepper we're going to put into there.
We're going to take some rosemary and we're just going to put like 2 tablespoons of rosemary in there. We're going to take our celery seeds and we're just going to pour like 2 tablespoons in there. We're going to take our Hungarian smoked paprika and we're going to put like 2 tablespoons in there. We're going to take our black sea salt and we're going to put like a teaspoon or so, probably about 1 tablespoon, because what this does is it brings the flavor of the fish out. So that's what. So we're gonna just move that around some and get all those spices up in there with that elephant garlic and that black salt and the olive oil, peppers. So basically what we're going to try to do is liquefy all this down, all the ingredients into like some form of base.
Our message to you, our viewers, is proceed with caution.
So even though this is very high sodium soy sauce, we're going to add it into there just for a little bit of taste and caramelization.
Sit back, watch, and enjoy.
So basically the liquid from the soy sauce is activating with the olive oil to caramelize or to facilitate the caramelization of the peppers in the elephant garlic.
The experimental and innovative arts and culture that make the world what it is.
This is my house and you in my house, so you ain't gonna disrespect me like that.
So what we're trying to do is caramelize all the ingredients.
You in my house, so you ain't gonna disrespect me like that.
And make a man offended to what? And lay a snare, you know, they try to trip a nigga up like me, you know, cause I ain't following Whitey's rules, you know.
Let that chill out there.
This is my house, and you in my house, so you ain't gonna disrespect me like that.
Parties, food, eateries, and exhibitions. The people, the places, and everything that is. Global, non-classified, random variety, artist music, TV.
an unspeakable tragedy confirmed to us by ABC News in New York City. John Lennon, outside of his apartment building on the west side of New York City, the most famous perhaps of all of the Beatles, shot twice in the back, rushed to Roosevelt Hospital, dead on arrival.
So, at this point, we have fish in the stainless steel pan. You want more liquids than you do actual content. You want to build a wall of liquids around the actual fish that is still raw. So you have that. You have that in the pan.
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt this program to bring you a special report from the United Shoestring Broadcasting News Service.
Live from Santa Barbara.
This week's episode, Danger at the Old Well.
Last one to the old well's a rotten egg. Ha ha, I win. Whoa! Ah! Someone fell down the well.
I'm wet.
What, Sassy? You know where Mr. Gunderson keeps his rope? Go get it, girl! What? You'd rather use this time to set people straight about shelter pet adoption?
I'm cold!
People shouldn't be afraid to adopt from a shelter? Because shelter pets are screened for sound, health, and temperament?
I'm wet and cold!
Sassy, what about Johnny? What? Let Johnny sit in the well until he learns to be more self-reliant?
Sassy is brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org. Remember, adopt.
So, this is a piece of salmon. I'm gonna take it to the bowl and just massage the bones. And my hands are clean, ladies and gentlemen. There's never bad part to a fish, ladies and gentlemen. Put a little bit in a tiny saucer, grab a roll, grab some mayo, and get the ball rolling. We gotta do a radio show. This is how I gotta eat on the road. We're out. The DMP Soul Hama Show. Cheers. Peace.
Whether learning about metropolitan travel on public transportation, random interviews with street musicians and passing locals, the pursuit of bizarre oddities and collectibles, or just hanging out with artists of all mediums, each of D'Ampa's adventures showcase archaic and spontaneous things that take place in the midst of unexpected times and places.